Hi everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I'm Damian and I'm joined today by Alex. Alex, what are we talking about?
Today we're talking about boosting your team's productivity by integrating your GitHub repo with Azure Boards.
Very cool, don't miss it. Hey everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I am Damian and today I am joined by Alex Nichols. Alex, thanks for joining me.
Good to be here.
So you are a program manager on the Azure Boards team. Right. Which is the part of Azure DevOps that deals with planning your work, essentially, right?
Right.
So we were talking a little bit, I'm guilty of this, a lot of the time when I talk about DevOps, I talk about code being built and deployed to production, built and deployed to your environments and then to production, but I don't really talk so much about the planning side of it. Right. And that's a big part of this whole DevOps lifecycle, right?
Right. Yeah, I'd say what we found with a lot of teams is, yes, code and builds and deployments are core to what they do. Mm-hmm. But what's also really important is staying aligned on what's most important next and keeping tabs on what you're working on right now so you don't get lost.
So what are the problems that this solves? Like if you're tracking your work properly, you're getting good visibility over what's happening, how does this lead to like better outcomes ultimately?
Yeah, so some of the things we've seen are when teams might, because you might start out simply, right, with a task list, mm-hmm. Or maybe using something that's native with your code, like maybe you're on GitHub, maybe you use GitHub Issues.
Yep.
Starts off okay, but then as things get maybe your product's popular, maybe more teams get involved, right? It starts to get pretty complicated. So a simple task list or just a running list of issues, there's a lot of work of different types mixed in there with bugs and features and all different kinds. And again, it's kind of tough to distill out of that. Okay, what's number one and what's number two and what's the team actively working on right now?
And I've been in those meetings before where they talk about, well, you should be fixing this many bugs and doing this many new features. But what's really important is what you want to surface, right, and what you want to get hold of.
Yeah.
So you mentioned GitHub Issues, and this is a way that I've actually worked with this before in previous companies where all of our work is tracked in GitHub Issues. But like you said, it's a big list of stuff, right? Azure Boards kind of tries to solve that problem by being a bit more structured. Is that one of the draw cards for that?
Yeah. I'd say we're really bringing Azure Boards to be that kind of next level of scale offering for teams. So, if your product's really popular or you have multiple teams working together in your organization, you can get a lot of the goodness of stitching those things together. So you can have one team working on this, one team working on that, rolling up to a common story that you're delivering together. Mm-hmm. And also providing leadership with some of the reporting around how the teams are doing.
Right. So that kind of, it helps with that planning process. If your code is not in Azure DevOps though, then that traceability is something that I've heard a lot. Like your code lives somewhere else, your planning tool lives in this location, and your CI/CD lives somewhere else potentially. Do you have to move from GitHub into Azure repos, or what are the real solutions here?
Yeah. So while Azure DevOps and each of the services within that suite work really great together, mm-hmm. and they have for a while, a few months ago we started to realize that we want to offer some of our key services independently. And Azure Pipelines is one, Azure Boards is one, where we're realizing that people want to start picking and choosing which services they use. So they might want to use GitHub for their code, Azure Pipelines for build, and then we want to be that offering as well in Azure Boards to help you plan your work.
So if your code is in GitHub, that integration with Azure Boards, I think you were saying that it was at Connect last year in December in 2018. Yeah. You released a kind of an integration between GitHub and Boards, is that right?
Right, yeah, so that integration is relatively new, just last December. Mm-hmm. And what that does is set up the foundation for bringing the work management in Azure Boards into your development workflow. So as you're doing your code, you might be wondering, hey, what's assigned to me next?
Yep.
I can pick that up, start writing my code, doing some commits, pushing that back, and as I'm doing my commits and my PRs, I can mention Azure Boards work items. So I can start to get that traceability between our definition of what's important versus the code that they're actually working on.
Okay, this is really useful. Can we have a look? Let's have a look at what that looks like, I guess, right from the Azure Boards or from the GitHub portion.
Yeah.
What does that look like, that process?
Yeah, so I'll dive into the example here where, you know, I might be working in this GitHub repository, mm-hmm. which is pretty straightforward, and maybe I realize that this is going to be, you know, pretty popular, or I've got a couple teams that I'm working with. Mm-hmm. So I'm considering using Azure Boards. I might go out to Bing and search, you know, hey, how do I use Azure Boards with GitHub? You'll go to some of our documentation where you can find everything you're looking for to get connected and learn about how you link commits and pull requests in GitHub to Azure Boards work items. So that's how you get started.
Okay. And then this is kind of trying to reduce this integration is trying to reduce that integration tax of having multiple different locations for your stuff, making sure it talks to, you know, the tools talk to each other in a nice way.
Exactly.
So it's not slowing you down.
Right. Yeah. You don't want to be slowed down by, you know, doing your code in one place, swiveling around into another system, and then keying it over there so that somebody else is happy, right? You want yep. these things to work together. You want them to work for you.
Yep. Yeah. Awesome.
So that's how you get started. Mm-hmm. And then I can, you know, if I'm interested in here, I can go ahead and try it for free. I can click up there and create a new organization. I've already got one set up, so I'll kind of show how you get the two products connected.
Okay.
The way you do that, and as you read through the documentation, you'll find that you can get started there by going into your project settings mm-hmm. for your project. And we've got this section for GitHub connections.
All right, so that's a native connection on Boards.
Right, yeah, so we built this natively. And what I'll do is I'll remove the one I had set up prior mm-hmm. to just show, you know, here's how easy it is to get set up. So big blue button,
yeah,
connect to your GitHub account. We do some magic here around authorizing. Since I'm already logged in, boom, right away I get the list of my repos to pick from.
That's very cool.
Yeah. Yep. So I'll pick this repo that I'm working in. That'll take a second, and now I'm connected.
Right. Okay.
So that's how you get started, get the connection set up. Now over, if I go back to my board, I see I already got a work item here. Mm-hmm. Let's maybe add another work item that says update the README on the repo, because, you know, I want to let the rest of my team know. You know, the README is the place where you let the team know how you're working with this project. So
yeah,
I want to let them know what they're doing there. So that's the work item. And I'm going to remember that work item ID number 14 you see there.
Yep.
That's going to come in a second here. So I'm going to go into my repo. And I'm just going to take the URL and I say, you know what, we're planning our work over here. That's what I want to do.
Okay.
So I'm going to edit my repo. Let's say I do that. And now I want to do a commit. And I'm going to create a new branch just for the purposes here. Mm-hmm. This is one place where I could link to the work item. I can use a mention syntax in the commit here.
Oh, right.
Okay. But maybe I prefer to do it over in the pull request. So I'm gonna go ahead and go over to the pull request. And I'm going to say fixes. I'm going to use our mention syntax, which is AB14.
So where does that AB come from?
Yeah, that's a way that we differentiate Azure Boards from the native mentions in GitHub, right? Because if I just said #14, GitHub would think, oh, it's issue 14.
Right? Yep, perfect.
So it helps to differentiate that. So let's see, if I bring that up here, and I want to bring up my commit here to show what's going on.
Yep.
So if I do this, I got my open pull request. I'm going to click create there. So now I've got my pull request going.
Yep.
And if I merge, we should see, right behind the scenes there.
Oh, whoa.
That work item actually resolved itself because I used the term fixes with the mention of the work item.
Wow. So because that integration set up, that was an automatic process to update the board right in front of you.
Right. We call those smart commits.
Yeah.
Smart mentions. Yeah.
Okay, that's very cool. So, I mean, I've seen this work with, you know, issues and so on in GitHub, but I haven't seen it work before in Azure Boards, actually.
Yeah.
So that's very cool. I noticed as well, and you called this out, you didn't mention that in the commit.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned it in the pull request, and then when it merged, it moved to closed.
Right.
If you mention it in the commit, that's still got a link, right?
Right, yeah, you can mention it in the commit. That'll link up to the work item.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, if I open this work item up, That's what facilitates that automation of moving the item.
Yep.
Was that you see in your development section now I can see, okay, this update README, it has a link to that pull request. So now I can jump between between GitHub back to and back up to Azure Boards.
So that that really reduces that kind of flipping between the two different tools. They're legitimately connected, and you get that traceability.
Right.
And of course, once you go forward and you create a build and then you do a release, that release will have a link back to the build, and the build will have a release. A link back to the commits that you've made and the pull requests.
Right. That's the beauty of it. And we've been doing this for a long time. We do a lot of this kind of work with Azure repos, but now we're excited to bring it to GitHub.
That's very cool. Yeah. And this is freely available for everybody, right? It's not a
There's no separate payment here. So as long as you got your GitHub repo, you get started with Azure Boards. First 5 users are free.
Yep.
So it's free to get started. Yeah.
That's fantastic. What one thing I wanted to ask you as well is what other stuff can we expect that's coming down the pipeline, I guess, for this integration? Because we keep seeing more and more integration with GitHub for fairly obvious reasons, I guess.
Right.
What's coming?
Yeah. So we're in early days, so we're really eager to get feedback. So as people try it, we want to hear. So we want this to be driven from the community too of what's important for them. But some of the things that we're thinking about right now are maybe if you're not if you're not replacing GitHub issues with Azure Boards, maybe you want to use them both together. So that could be a situation where I'm developing in the public with my repo, and GitHub issues is where the community is filing suggestions and bugs against my project. But maybe I want to use Azure Boards internally to plan my future investments. So that might be a place where I want to use them together.
Yep.
And gosh, it would be nice if I could link between GitHub issues and Azure Boards work items to see, to tie work together that's related.
Yeah.
So that's one area that we're investing in, is bringing GitHub issue to Azure Boards work item integration.
Right. And I imagine that's the kind of thing that people are solving that problem with little hacks and workarounds and things like that.
Right. Yeah, I mean, you can copy hyperlinks around and stuff to work around it, but yeah, having a native link just like this in your work item is the magic there.
One thing I didn't see as well, that link back from GitHub back in the other direction, is that a link as well, or is that something that you can get to easily?
So that's one of the other things that we're actually working on right now, because you see, right? There's no link right there.
Yeah.
But we've actually got teams working on that to linkify that text right there as we speak, actually.
That's
coming fairly soon.
Nice.
Yeah.
Didn't mean to throw you in the deep end there, but
that's good. That's a good one.
Good answer. Awesome. So this is, I guess this integration is just going to deepen, right, between GitHub and Azure Pipelines and GitHub and Azure Boards especially.
Right. Yeah. We definitely want to deepen our Azure Boards integration. This is just the tip of the iceberg here. But certainly with Azure Pipelines too, and getting that full traceability story. Mm-hmm. I also wanted to mention that this is also available on-prem. So if you're using GitHub Enterprise Server, that's just coming out now with Azure DevOps Server 2019. So this integration is there too. So whether you're all in the cloud or you're all in the on-prem, and we're also looking at bringing the hybrid scenario. So if you want to keep your code in GitHub Enterprise on-prem, you can quickly fire up Azure Boards in the cloud and get started with this.
That's very cool. Yeah. I didn't actually expect that at all. So this is a big thing for customers who are moving to these new tools. They're like, well, our code lives here. We don't want to move the code just to enable these scenarios. So having that integration in a hybrid scenario is very cool. Or just on-prem. Wow. Yeah. That's very cool. We will post links to the docs and so on in the
absolutely,
show notes as well. But thank you so much for showing me this. I think I'm going to actually start to do some of these integrations in my demos as well. If people have questions and more information, they can use the feedback tools in Azure DevOps, I'm guessing.
We've got a developer community site out there where you can file suggestions or problems that you run into. And we're right on the end of that.
That's awesome. Well, thanks so much for showing us this.
Thank you.
And join us next time for another DevOps Lab.